Another method that we can use in biochemistry to help us locate a specific protein that we want to study is Western blotting. And just like in the ELISA methods, Western blotting also utilizes antibodies. So the entire point in a Western blot is to form a specific antibody that can bind onto that protein that we want to locate. And when this process of binding takes place, it somehow allows us to visualize where that protein is, as we'll see in just a moment. So let's begin by supposing we have a sample of proteins. Now, where did the sample actually come from? So suppose we have a collection of cells, and inside the cells, we have proteins. And the protein that we want to actually locate is found within the cells. So the way that we're going to isolate the proteins from inside the cells is by fractionating our cells and then placing that fraction into a differential centrifuge machine. And then as a result of centrifugation, we're going to basically isolate the proteins found inside our cell. Now, once we isolate the protein sample, we take the sample of proteins and place it into a gel electrophoresis setup. So we use SDS polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis, and that allows us to use an electric field to separate the proteins based on their size. So this is what we get following our gel electrophoresis experiment. And so this band represents those proteins that are the largest in size, and this band represents the proteins that are the smallest in size. Remember, in SDS, polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis, these proteins move as a result of charge, as a result of being inside an electric field. And the largest proteins move the slowest because they have the greatest resistance. Now, once we form the setup, we also basically want to form the monoclonal antibody that is specific for that protein that we want to study. And that protein that we want to study, we call the antigen. So we synthesize this monoclonal antibody, we call the primary antibody, that can bind to that antigen, the protein that we actually want to locate. Now, once we form the monoclonal antibody and once we run gel electrophoresis, we then transfer that separated protein sample onto a polymer sheet. And this step is basically done to make it easier for us to work with our separated protein mixture. Now, the next step is to take this polymer sheet and we mix it with this antibody that we formed in step one. And once we mix these two mixtures, this antibody, the primary antibody, it will basically bind onto the proteins found in one of these bands, because one of these bands will contain that antigen that is specific for this protein. And so let's suppose it's the second band from the top that contains the proteins that we want to study. And so this antigen or this antibody will bind to the antigen, the protein found in the second band. So the monoclonal antibody is added onto the polymer sheet containing the separated protein mixture. And it only binds onto the antigen, onto the protein that we actually are interested in. Now, in step number five, we synthesize yet another antibody, and now we synthesize an antibody that is radioactively labeled. And what that allows us to do in the final step is to visualize exactly where that protein is. Now, the antibody that we want to synthesize the second time around, this antibody in step number five, is known as the secondary antibody. And the secondary antibody is made so that it binds onto that primary antibody that we formed in step one. So once we form this secondary radioactively labeled antibody, we then mix this mixture of antibody with our polymer sheet that contains that antigen that is bound to the primary antibody. And what happens is, because this was formed to bind onto this blue primary antibody, this complex is formed. So the polymer sheet containing the antibody antigen complex is now exposed to a solution containing the radioactively labeled antibody. So we take the green mixture of antibodies we reacted with the polymer sheet that contains the blue antibody bound onto the protein found on this second band. Now, the radioactive antibody will only bind to this band and not the other bands because only this second band contains this protein, the antibody bound onto the antigen, because this was built specifically to bind onto this primary blue antibody. Now, in the final step, we basically take an X-ray film, we expose it to X-rays, and what that allows us to do is allows us to visualize exactly where this radioactively labeled antibody has bound to, and because it is bound to the protein found on the second band, and none of these other bands contain this one bound to them, that means only the second band will appear dark on an X-ray film. And that allows us to exactly pinpoint where that protein is, the protein that we want to study. And now we can take the protein and isolate the protein from this particular location on that X-ray film.